and you can be, like I mentioned, the weresharks have breeds. They also don't have metas. Simply because weresharks don't see breeding with anything but sharks. Palatable. In the book, one of the characters asks about it, if they mate with each other, and the guy he asks that from is like, "What? Huh? The thought never occurred to me," kind of thing. They don't exist. There's no rules. There's even a part that's for secret information for the storyteller. They don't exist. Maybe some of them have tried and it doesn't work, but they are not drawn to each other. The Gnosis, the weresharks do not have the same relationship with the spirit world. They cannot step sideways the way werewolves can to enter the spirit world. Every wereshark, though, does enter the spirit world once, when they turn for the first time, because the sea calls them, to the spirit world. The weresharks cannot enter the spirit world without the sea's permission, and it hardly ever comes except when they are, when they turn, and then the sea gives them their auspice, their role. And the weresharks have three auspices. They have the dim water, the bright water, and the dark waters. Basically, bright waters are born when there's full moon, and they are the hunters. Then the dark waters are born when there's no moon, they are the seers, the shamans, and such. And then the dim waters are pretty much a mixture of Ragabash, Galliard, and Philodox. They are very much the leaders. They are the patient, smart people who do mostly the talking and who do the leading, basically, and use their smarts and wits, basically. Also with the Gnosis, they have the weresharks have their own cairns, but their cairns are called grottos, and the grottos are in the bottom of the sea. So not even every weresharks can enter there, and they swim through the sea's bottom in order to enter the spirit world. And though goblin sharks can step sideways, and dark water auspice weresharks can too later when they can get the appropriate gift for stepping sideways, the goblin sharks just for some reason happen to have that ability. Also, weresharks do not regain Gnosis the way werewolves do. Weresharks have... because they don't enter the spirit world as often, in the sea there are so-called spirit animals. Animals who are pretty much spirits in physical form. These are the remora, basically the small fish that tag along with sharks and whales and stuff to eat stuff that falls off from their mouths. They are spirit animals, and they work as messengers under the sea. And dolphins and whales also are spirit animals. They are these kind of zen-like creatures who are one with spirit, and that's why their protection is a great priority for the weresharks. And also... they grant you Gnosis. The weresharks, like I said before, don't have tribes. They have breeds, with either being a shark-born or a human-born, though human-borns are so rare that you can just forget about that. Then they have the three auspices I just listed, and then they have species. These species have nothing to do with tribes. They have no racial history or anything. They are just more of an appearance thing, and then every species has a couple of plus features to them. Tiger sharks are good in resisting any type of poison or toxin, because as you know, tiger sharks eat anything. They are the ones whose stomachs get open and you find license plates from there. Great white sharks have more rage. There's like hammerhead sharks get one minus difficulty to sight-based perceptual vision rolls. Bull sharks can survive in fresh water and in sea water, in salt water. Mako sharks have one minus difficulty on rolls to leap. All this sort of stuff, so it's more of a whatever fancies you, and there's, you can be of any shark species, and you can work out with the game master what sort of pluses that species would give you. The weresharks regenerate exactly as werewolves do as well, and the weresharks have this... The weresharks do not speak. They have what they call the sending. The weresharks send kind of these sound waves under the water, but they can do it on land as well, that other weresharks and the remora can pick up. And they speak to one another that way. That way, and that can be heard from a mile away. You can call somebody who's from a mile away. But when you're on land, it becomes a problem. Do you know how to speak? That's something you have to buy with freebie points. You cannot buy linguistics when you're creating your character other than with freebie points. And even then, it stresses that you must have a good reason, that your character must have a history of being on land in order to be able to speak. And that's pretty much the way they find they are Rokea. When the shark reaches its sexual maturity, it does not have an experience where it feels rage and it changes forms. It starts to send. It starts to use the sending on its itself, and this is kind of usually the first messages heard from somebody's first sendings are just, "What's going on? Help! Somebody help me! What is this?" And, you know, a remora or another wereshark will hear that and come to their aid and help them prepare for the long swim, which is when they learn everything there is to learn, and they need to learn from being a wereshark. And that's pretty much all of the basics. And then there's the wereshark cosmology, which I will not go too much into detail, but they do not worship Gaia and believe in a wild weaver and the worm. They believe in their own little thing. They believe in the sea, the unsea, and the oversea, meaning basically the ocean, land, and sky. And the sea gave birth to three daughters, Kun, Ket, and Quirl. Kun made all the sharks and fish and all that sort of thing in the sea. Ket is the mother of all crustaceans, and Quirl is the mother of all spineless creatures like octopuses and some coral-dwelling underwater animals. And they created all these animals in the sea. Then they went to the land, to the unsea, and wanted to make creations there too. Kun created all the mammals, Ket created all the insects, and Quirl created all the slugs and snails and all that sort of slimy, creepy crawlers. And after that, they looked toward the sky, and they wanted to make creations there too. Gun created all the birds, Ket created flying insects, but Quirrell wasn't invited to that sort of, that creation, Shindy. So she became very jealous, and she wanted to meet the sky, the oversea, herself. And she went secretly there and tried to grab the oversea and pull it to her to be one with the oversea. And her tentacles hurt the oversea greatly and wounded it. And that's why there are stars and the moon. The those are wounds made by Quirrell's tentacles. And that is why silver hurts the weresharks, because it's the blood of the moon, blood of the oversea. And the whole pattern of the moon is the oversea trying to mend his wounds, but not being able to do it correctly, and that's why the full moon comes again, and all that. And then there's all sorts of details and stories that would take forever to go into. Basically, the weresharks believe in the sea, unsea, oversea, and the daughters of the sea, Gun, the mother of the weresharks, and all sharks, and all mammals, and all that, the Ket, mother of all the crustaceans and insects, and all that, and Quirrell, mother of all the slugs and octopuses and such. And these are more like Greek gods, more than spiritual entities like the worm, weaver, and wild. And comparing, if somebody were to compare that these are just, okay, they're different names, but they're basically the were-shark version of wild, weaver, and the worm, that would be kind of like saying that Muhammad is the Muslim version of Jesus. That's how simple-minded it would be, because they are active creatures in the world. Quirrell is actually a giant anthropomorphic octopus who lives in the bottom of the sea, and they actually affect the world with their actions. But weresharks do fight Quirrellings, who are the creatures of Quirrell, and Quirrell is a very jealous and very bitter character who affects the world mainly very negatively, because of her frustration and anger towards, you know, her sisters and all that sort of thing. So yeah, that's about it. Weresharks, they're fucking awesome.